if it's the Bears who have to ban it themselves.
Well, we'll have to see how this plays out for them. We know there are a couple of contested picks here, and both of these top laners like to run Shen. No, both of the mid laners like their Ahri and their Orianna and Fizz. We see the bans. Gamma Bears have taken out Corki, Aatrox, and Zed. Yep. As you've already highlighted, on that blue side, it's something they don't want to play against at all.
But what he does have open is his Ahri, which is a pretty important one for him. Maple does a very good job on Ahri, making a bunch of plays throughout the mid lane. And I also have to respect SKT banning away Thresh, because Sword Art is scary good. Now, his Sona's great as well. He really doesn't miss his Flash Crescendos, and that's really powerful. But you give him Thresh, he's going to land all those hooks as well.
Well, we'll see how it pans out for them. Thresh was that third and final ban from SKT. The very first lock-in is going to be that Elise. So not only are they locking that in for themselves, they're denying it from Bengi. If you remember how SKT demolished OMG in the last group stage game, mm-hmm. Quite a bit of that was the cocoons and the charms from Bengi and from Faker.
And of course, the Ahri is still available as well, which is a bit of a scary thing here. You've got to kind of be afraid of that one. Of course, the Varus, not a surprising pick here at all for NL. He played basically Caitlyn and Varus the entire time in the last couple of months. So with the Caitlyn being stolen away there, I actually have to respect the early pick there from SKT. It kind of guarantees the other side. The Zyra being taken away is actually Mandu's most played support here at Worlds, so he's going to have to take kind of a rung down and probably play the Sona there himself.
Well, we'll see how it works out for them. Faker is going to lock in that Ahri, making it to the third round of picks. A little bit non-traditional for what we're seeing on most of the games this tournament. We have been seeing a lot of priority on those single, you know, assassin type mid laners. Mm-hmm. And of course, for their jungle, it is going to be Vi. So we'll see Bengi on another, you know, very powerful ganking jungler once he hits that level 6.
And that is really going to be a tricky thing here, because if we do see Maple go for Kassadin, he's notably weak pre-6. And that's going to be an interesting thing to deal with, because Vi is not the best ganker pre-6. A soul laner should reach the ultimate before a jungler could. But if you do something crazy, Bang gets a really good gank, or he gets a lot of help in the jungle or something, or you force Maple back a couple of times, you might get those assault and batteries before Riftwalk, which could completely just demolish that lane.
All right, we'll see how this works out for them, because I just think you remember the odd one running that jungle Vi against Nuke Dux Ahri. And yep. That Spirit Rush didn't allow you to get away. It's going to be a similar situation. That Bengi should be able to just lock on and completely shut down their Kassadin once he hits 6. 3 seconds left to go in this pick and ban, and the Gamma Bears are going to lock in Kassadin and Shyvana. So most likely going to be a top lane Shyvana?
That's my guess here.
That's what my gut's telling me.
Yeah, from what I've been told by other pro top laners, Renekton's actually a good matchup to play as when you're fighting an Elise. You can generally sustain through it. You have pretty good trades as well, and so I don't think they want to fight that matchup. Shyvana, on the other hand, though, has really good one-on-one trading. Shyvana can proxy waves if she wants to as well. And there's still a lot of pushing pressure there that can actually keep impact away from the rest of the team. Honestly, both these top laners, you'll see picks like this the rest of the way through. They're heavy brawlers who want to fight things.
So the SK Telecom team is a lot more traditional from what we've been seeing from the Worlds. These are all picks that have been, you know, trended towards, with the exception of maybe the Nami. I think this may be her first appearance, actually.
He played it once already in the group stage, but only the one time here. Yeah. So SKT's pretty much got sort of their style of lineup. They've got the easy, safe backline. They've got the ability to dive into fights with Ahri, Nami, Vi, and Renekton. So they've got a bunch of chaos. And then Piglet's just there shooting people in the back lines, relatively safe. It's a good SKT lineup.
Relatively safe. We'll see how well that Shyvana and Elise can get to him. And while the teams are loading into the very first game of this best of three, let's take a look who you guys at home think is going to win this series. According to LOLesports.com, 72% of you think that SKT will be taking on Najin Black Sword in the semifinals.
Yeah, and of course, the analysts said SKT as well. Honestly, these guys were the favorites to win the whole thing before we ever even saw them play. We're looking at them now. You heard the analysts say how scary they are. Certainly, the SKT lineup is merciless. But I always want to play the underdog story. It's one of my favorite things to talk about. Gamma Bears here are in the exact same position as Taipei Assassins last year. They have to play a Korean team in the quarterfinals. Oh, yeah, that's going to be hilarious, right? Sword's going to demolish them. No. Right, and the entire way through, TPA was the sleeper who kept hitting there. And you know, maybe the Bears are coming out of hibernation.
We'll have to see how well they perform on the Rift. They've already pulled out. That's a sigh from the audience. I like these guys.
That was not applause.
I definitely want to see how this composition is going to work out for them. We have seen a top lane Shyvana once this tournament already. Darian ran against Fnatic, and I was not particularly impressed by it. You can see we are loading onto the Rift, ladies and gentlemen, for the third quarterfinal of Worlds. It's the Gamma Bears taking on SK Telecom T1. And we'll see how well this team comp works for them. We talked about how they're a little more difficult to scout, and we're already seeing a composition that we have not seen from them this weekend. All the crowd control is actually mostly coming from their duo lane. You can see that large numbers of SK Telecom are hanging out in and around the river.
Hey, this is just interesting because you talked about the unscoutability. A lot of these picks are completely new for the Gamania Bears. The top laner and mid laner specifically are things that wouldn't have been easily scouted. These are new things they've picked up that SKT is going to have to adapt their bans to as this game goes through. But we're looking at the level 1 setups here, and it's I think, proper deep warding. These are wards that will let these teams know the jungle routes so that teams will know if they're about to get ganked or if they're safe to push really hard. And those are just important for the first 3 to 4 minutes of the game to know what you can get away with.
Well, we'll see how the teams do decide to settle their lanes. There is a lot of options available to try and shut down your opponent's solo laners if they wanted to go for those lane swaps. But as it stands, we may be having head-to-head matchups as both of these teams just do this warding dance, really. They've got full vision of one another over the last 20 or 30 seconds, and it doesn't look like we're going to have any invades.
No real invades, just for the wards right there. And both these teams got relatively equal information out of this, though SKT's ward in the bottom jungle is a little bit deeper. At the end of the day, it really just means they'll see when they go towards red buff and near the wraiths and whatnot, and it tracks jungle movements. That's what those wards are for. And when you consider how scary jungle Elise is, the fact that you can gank for Zyre with a 0.75 second root, I believe it's a 1.5 second stun off Cocoon, you can kill someone with that kind of damage. So it's important for SKT specifically to know where Winz is going.
Well, we'll see how well it works out for them. You can see Winz starting on his blue buff while Bengi is about to secure his own buff. And we're going to have this straight up 1v1 matchup. You can see Faker already just landing auto attack after auto attack onto that melee carry of Kassadin. We'll see how well Maple can do in this mid lane because Faker's Ahri has been incredibly good throughout this tournament.
We've already got an inkling of offense, though. You actually saw Bengi running down early on. He didn't actually decide to get anything for that. But the one thing to point out, actually, is that the duo lane for the Gamania Bears is pushing first. They're actually going to have level 2 first. They'll have the ability to trade a little bit more. And dealing with Zyra spawning plants on you, like, forever and ever is very difficult. They're actually going to go in... Ooh, almost.
A little excited there. Gospel Roots not landing on Mandu. He's able to sidestep it, but we do see a small CS advantage for NL thanks to that aggressive pushing on this bottom lane. They managed to push the wave up to the tower, so this should reset lane overall. And you see Maple falling behind in the CS in the mid lane, 6-11, but that is to be expected in this matchup.
It is going to happen right here. It's a melee versus range matchup, and Kassadin's forced to last it with spells half the time. And as you've sort of seen, even from Peke's Kassadin and whatnot, you can sit there, as long as you don't die or miss XP, you're pretty much going to do okay as far as a Kassadin lane goes. It's really when you get the tier and the catalyst completed that you sort of turn on. When you hit close to level 13, you really start getting abusive and scary. So that's the lineup we're going to look for here. One thing I want to point out for the Bears, though, is they've hit literally every minion in the bottom lane so far. 19 is perfect for this point.
Well, we'll see if they can keep that one up. NL, we talked about him coming into this matchup. He does have that passive CSing style in the laning phase. He likes to farm a lot during the qualifiers against the likes of the Taipei Snipers. He was actually averaging about 10 CS a minute for the majority of that playoff bracket. So mechanically, very strong, and he's on one of his most played AD carries. So pretty good start for them. We'll see if we can secure the kills, though, because that's what's really going to help them get objectives. And we still see the mid lane Maple falling behind on those CS numbers.
One thing I am going to point out, though, as we kind of look through these lanes, though, is that ward control is in favor of the Bears at the bottom lane right here. There's, like, one ward and a brush, but if this lane ever resets, the Elise from Winz can sneak in and force a gank here. And Nami doesn't escape all that well. They could probably pick her up with Grassroots in a Cocoon.
See if they can manage to land any of that CC. That's what's going to help them pick those kills up. Maple now chugging through his very last potion as Bengi does once again roam to look for an invade. He's going to run into Winz. The Cocoon does land as well as the Volatile Spiderling. Bengi's going to charge up the Vault Breaker. Does manage to get up, but we see Winz is chasing for this one. He does rappel forward. Now there's no Spur Rush down in the bottom lane. Piglet's now in trouble. He's cleansed the Ignite. That's a flash ball from NL. A great bubble from Mandu. Throws NL up in the air. NL continues to auto attack down. And we see Mandu force backwards. That's a 2v2 win for the Gamma Bears.
Yeah, it's three summoners belts with three summoners for three summoners, but really good trade right there. There's only a flash up for Mandu and a barrier for NL. And now you can see Winz. I like this move by him. He's come to the mid lane to shove it out to allow Maple to run back to base. A fight in the top lane.
Oh, Impact's going to slice out. Does have that dice available. Not going to be needed as now Bengi's coming in from the river. The question is, can he get onto Stake? Stake's caught between a rock and a hard place. He may be able to pick up first blood. Impact gets away. That's a flash. Flash for flash. Bengi lands the killing blow, securing for SKT.
Very well played right there by Impact, making sure he didn't take too much damage. And that was the gank we also needed to see coming, was neither of these top laners came in with wards in their opening build. And you saw it capitalized there by Bengi. Well played.
Congratulations to Bengi and Impact there, able to give them even more of a lead up top. Their Stake is already 10 CS behind. Thanks to Wynn's sort of babysitting that middle lane a little bit, Maple still holds on to that 10 CS deficit, and he's about to hit level 6, and once he's got that Riftwalk available, it's going to be much more difficult to catch him and lock him down.
It looks like he'll hit that level 6 mark in time to survive any of the major ganks, and we'll probably see him be okay. The other thing to point out, though, is that even though that bottom lane should have went well for the Bears, the one thing to point out, actually, is that they both went back to base and got the same items. Both AD carries have Vamp Scepter and Doran's Blade, so the CS lead doesn't mean much yet.
Oh, take a look at this. NL and Sword Art going super aggressive, but now the bubble catches Sword Art out. We do see Piglet not going in for more auto attacks, but thanks to that bubble, they do trade relatively evenly.
And Wynn's looking for a counter gank here in this mid lane, expecting Faker to go in, but he won't jump into that minion wave, so this will take a while for anything to pay off for Wynn's.
Oh, the charm does land though. Maple gets the silence down. Faker still not used that Spirit Rush. They decide to continue fighting. Up in the top lane, Stake is actually doing very well in the 1v1 against Impact. However, it does look like Dragon's Descent was used, so Ultimate's going to be unavailable until he's got all that Rage built back up.
And Impact still has his, so you're going to have the Dominus back available. But Wynn's just showing up for the bottom lane. Gets spotted by a Cupcake, though.
Does manage to get caught out. Piglet is going to back away just a little bit. You've seen Bengi. He's hanging out in that bottom lane as well. Assault and Battery is available, so a squishy Zyra or a squishy Varus could be squished into the ground if they decide to go in. Maple, once again, just CSing in this mid lane against Faker. And it does look like Bengi is backing off on the minimap.
Yeah, it looks like nothing's going to really happen here. I do want to point out, though, this top lane you were talking about, because even before the kill, Impact had a pretty large minion kill lead, holds on to a level lead right now as well, and Impact has gone for early magic resist. That's actually most of the damage that Shyvana deals with her burnout, with her flame breath. This is going to be an interesting fight, though.
Oh, we do see Impact. He throws down the Dominus, slices him, just manages to chase Stake back. Stake still trying to build up that fury. Impact now with some minions behind him. Don't think he's going to be confident enough to dive without that ignite, but got himself a chunk of HP and is going to sustain a little bit in lane thanks to getting that back.
Absolutely. So Impact's honestly going to probably keep scaling up in this lane. He's just plus a Negatron Cloak right now, has the same other items. So that's probably going to be a point where Wynn's needs to turn something around, or Impact will be very hard to deal with in these fights. It's something to keep in mind in this game.
Well, Wynn's, we've seen him moving to that mid lane to help cover off some of those minions. Faker, only 10 CS ahead. In the bottom lane, Mandu's now managed to flash away. These do see NL, he's just hit level 6. Chain of Corruption could come out. He's got the mana for it. Decides against it thanks to that massive minion wave in front of him. But Pumandu's only on a couple hundred hit points. Bengi is waiting in the wings, though.
Oh, and they've got the Renekton as well. This is going to be a 3-on-2 in SKT's favor.
That was a great silence onto Bengi. Meant the Assault and Battery couldn't come out. Maple tries to get the blue buff, but Bengi is going to smite that one away. Now Bengi charges the Vault Breaker and gets out cleanly. So a good blue buff steal there from SKT.
That was incredibly well played right here. I don't think Gaminia Bears can capitalize anything here. Bottom lane is taking more damage.
Oh, Tidal Wave actually gets pulled out. Bumandu was afraid of the committed attacker from Gamma Bears, and this is going well. You do see NL still 10 CS in the lead. Well, Bengi's going to secure his red buff in the background, but they're trading blow for blow with the exception of that first blood.
And the buff steals, though, start to push yourselves towards SKT. There was actually an early gold lead for Gaminia Bears, but even if you subtract the 600 gold lead that SKT has from the first blood, they actually still hold pretty equally despite the buff steals, despite everything else. I have to say, lanes are completely holding on right now. What's going to matter is actually the teamwork, the mid-game rotations, which is the one point we have praised SKT for the entire tournament. If there's one strength that's going to win them the game, it's the core SKT strength.
Well, we'll see if they can make it work for them. As it stands, no pressure has been applied to Dragon, as we do see Bengi moving his way towards this bottom half of the map. Still has not used that Assault and Battery either. Remember that NL is alone in this lane. Here comes Bengi from behind. The bubble doesn't land. The Vault Breaker does. Assault and Battery should be channeled in the not-too-distant future. In the background, Piglet and Mandu were locked up by the Chain of Corruption, but it was all too easy for Gamma Bears as they secure this, for SKT as they secure the second kill.
And look how coordinated that was. Pink wards all over the river, or towards the bottom lane for the river, for Mandu to make sure that Bangi got to get in there for free without getting spotted. Those are the kind of moves we're going to keep seeing. Bangi has both the kills. Keep that in mind, so it's actually on him to do well in the fights as we move forward.
Well, Stake right now does have the option to dive into that dragon form onto impact. However, playing in a little bit more passively. Now finally dives in. Dominus has just been popped, so they've traded ultimate for ultimate. Impact is going to have much more sustain thanks to that Cole the Meek. And we'll see if he jumps on him. For the time being, just
not
using
good
that
for
AoE to at least farm up. A flash away from Stake into Burnout. Decides to back away, a little afraid of Bengi's presence.
Stake now, Stake, why? Bengi's going to get this
one. Bengi comes in, the red buff is busy sticking. Impact throws down the ignite, plus the damage over time. That's a flash ball from Bengi to get the last auto attack and kill number three for SK Telecom.
Very well done. Bengi has all of them, keep that in mind. And this mid lane already almost going down. Faker doing a very good job in this matchup as well. You're seeing the game just start pushing more and more and more towards SKT's favor.
Very good charm there onto Wins as well. Gets a lot of additional damage onto that jungle Elise. He's going to be forced to back away. I think the best he can to farm does have a 15 CS lead over Bengi, but it's 3 kills down, so there's a pretty big disparity there as far as gold available. Charm goes out once again, connecting with Maple. Maple actually goes in. This may be more than he should have chewed. Flashes out cleanly, afraid of the Sultan battery, but wasn't available for Bengi to use.
And it's worth pointing out that all the money that's gone into Bengi has been dumped into a very fast Oracles. I feel like he's going to live here. There's a fast Oracles and fast Boots of Mobility, so Bengi will keep finding openings like this, but has no combat stats, which is why you're seeing Wins do so well here.
Well, Wins does a lot of damage, does force Bengi away. Vault Break is out, he does get out cleanly. However, Sword Art is now caught. We do see the bubble lands. Tidal Wave follows as well. NL decides not to use that Chain of Corruption. Now, Dragon is still standing. Neither team has made a move for it, and as it stands, SKT are just accelerating ahead in the gold values. Already a 3,000 gold lead with only kills and CS on the board.
That's very well done by them, and even though Bengi got forced out of lane, there's just not enough power on the map for the Bears right here. Their dual lanes are basically equal. They traded an ultimate for health, which is rather important in a team fight, and so even on what would be a 4v3, Bears can't go for these kind of moves.
Well, DC Piglet gets rooted up, takes a lot of damage. The Chain of Corruption doesn't connect. Once again, we see a Varus ultimate miss. I'm sure nobody in the audience has ever seen that before. And SK Telecom managed to get away. However, Gamma Bears have started Dragon.
This is risky. They actually decided to go when Faker left instead of when Bengi left, so the smite war could happen here.
Now there's no Tidal Wave available. We do see Bengi with the Sultan Battery available. Does look like SKT are going to back away from this one, and Gamma Bears hold on to the goal difference as they secure the first Dragon of the game.
That's very, very well done. We actually saw Stake pulling his way down the map partway until they realized SKT weren't looking to really engage in that battle, so Stake went back. But that matchup, these top lane bruisers were going to keep pushing against each other. You're seeing now a 20 minion kill lead grow for Impact, which is rather valuable. These guys are going to keep throwing their stats at each other, and Impact's going to have more of them.
And as it stands right now, is nearing a 50 CS advantage for Faker in that mid lane. It was even for a very long time, but with Maple's tower going down and the inability to stay in that lane, he has lost significantly more CS. And of course, it was picked up by Wins the times he was covering those lanes out. We do see that both Bengi and Faker are moving towards the bottom half of the map, so this could be a 4v3 in favor of SKT.
And they've got pretty good ward coverage. You saw the Oracles, the pink wards already used. They're going to be able to go into this one without getting spotted.
Well, Wins is going to be around to counter gank and see if they can manage to pick up a kill before SKT get the numbers advantage. We talked about how Shyvana could do that sort of lane cutting. As it stands, Impact on Renekton is going behind the tower. Wins throws himself at Piglet. Chain of Corruption is not available. That looked like a flash forward. No, it wasn't. It was just a move there. Tidal Wave is going to slow all of the Gamma Bears. And SKT managed to get out with just the use of that Tidal Wave.
And as Tax were going to the bottom lane, the blue buff has once again been stolen here by Bengi. Really good read there by the Vi player. And we've noticed now that Maple has not gotten a blue buff all game and is falling behind now 50 minions away from Faker.
I don't think Faker has missed one of those charms yet. Every time we look at him applying damage to these mid lane towers, he's catching Maple out. He's catching Wins out. We'll have to see if it does result in kills. A three-man Gamma Bears is now hammering away on this bottom tower. However, a little nervous about their HP bars and they back away. Piglet now with the CS advantage against NL. All of that early aggression hasn't worked out in Gamma Bears' favor.
It really hasn't for these guys, unfortunately. The minion leads you're seeing grow and grow every single lane. The levels going up for them. And Bengi, of course, standing on pink wards, worrying in Oracles. Maple will not see this coming either.
Well, we'll wait for the Assault and Battery. Is going to follow in. Here comes Faker. Maple tries to get away. He is going to get taken down. And that Assault and Battery just locking up Kassadin for too long. Not even he could escape it.
Yeah, well played by Faker. He saved the charm until it was guaranteed. They knew their first attacks were going to miss thanks to Riftwalk. But once the Assault and Battery, just one more push forward by Ahri, and they're going to have the lockdown. Well-executed gank. And honestly, this can just keep happening over and over again against Maple.
SKT now approaching the 4,000 gold lead. They have two towers in their back pockets. They didn't secure the first dragon. I'm sure they'll be willing to fight for the next one as their power spike is a little bit higher. We see that Maple is sort of rushing that Rod of Ages right now. Decided to forego the likes of a TL or even a Chalice, as I've seen some Kassadin's build. But we'll have to keep our eyes on his itemization and see how it works out. NL forced back by the auto attacks of Piglets.
And it's going to keep happening here, honestly. You're now starting to see the individual skill really stack up for SKT. And they're just controlling the game. The thing is, they've never been the most hyper-aggressive team. They don't dive a lot. They'll gank you on your turn if it's there.
Yeah. He does manage to cleanse out of that Chain of Corruption and the rest of Gamma Bears. It was a bit of a half-hearted gank, but the chain did connect, and it did get the summoner spell.
Yeah, so SKT, honestly, they're happy to play the control game. An aggressive control game, to be fair, where they'll take anything that's there for them. But you've seen from the buff steals, from the turrets going down now, two of them so far. It's just going to be controlled aggression rolling over the map here for SKT. For the Bears, they've got to learn how to actually make some plays. They've got Catalyst on Kassadin. He's spiked up. They can use him.
Oh, we do see a root now lands onto Piglet. There's no chain available. A very good tidal wave from Pumandu. He actually exhausts Sword Art though. NL throws out the piercing arrow, does not connect, as now Piglet throws out his Piltover Peacemaker. Ace in the hole is channeled, doesn't secure a kill. Now Bengi comes in from the side. Rappel lands onto Piglet, gets caught in the bubble. Piglet is still alive. Faker comes from the background. They've killed AD carry for AD carriers. Now Pumandu is the next target. We do see Winds getting dropped by Bengi as Maple is chasing forward. He's got one. Ignite may get number two. Assault and Battery plus the tower and the shield is not going to be enough to save Bengi as a double kill is secured for Maple.
That was very, very good because that was the shutdown gold as well onto Bengi. So Maple just got massive. This is going to be a fun game for Kassadin. Look at this fight. So good barrier by NL keeps him alive. And Winds just has nice low cooldowns. Piglet just gets to be jumped on. Despite an amazing bubble there by Mandu, Faker wastes every major cooldown and is now basically out of the fight. He's got to get over a wall with basically one dash left. And so he can't reach Sword Art anymore. And Maple just gets to be a Kassadin who's not getting bursted down. Kassadin's actual DPS, very, very high, and he's going to take kill after kill after kill.
Well, works in his favor, and now we'll see whether or not he can make it count. His Rod of Ages has just been completed. 2-1-0. He is 90 CS behind Faker right now, which is an incredible amount, and all of SKT's solo lanes are now starting to pull ahead. 177 to 142 for the top laners. 157 to 139 for the AD carries. So SKT, even though they gave up a couple of kills, they still hold on to about a 5,000 gold lead, and they're still looking very good for the next fights.
And the gold is actually in a lot of really good plays for SKT as well. Impact is up about 1,400 gold over his lane opponent, which so you're seeing like he has Spirit Visit versus the makings of a Sunfire Cape. Look at Faker, he's 1,600 gold up, despite Maple getting that double kill in the shutdown muddy. And SKT, look at this. They do it with Baron a lot. They're doing this bait with Dragon to a certain extent, seeing if someone's wanting to look from the side. Instead, they'll just get free neutral objectives and continue to grow their gold lead.
Yeah, we've talked about how Faker likes to just destroy support when he's on any of the assassins, and SKT pick up an uncontested Dragon. Nobody from Gammon Bears was brave enough to move in there. They didn't have any vision in the pit. I think they were going to be fully aware of SKT's positioning. Stake and Winds now trying to get some damage on the top lane tower, but Impact is going to respond in time and clears the wave with a couple of abilities.
And one thing actually as I looked down the lineups as well that I sort of wanted to see from Gmania Bears was actually putting some pressure onto Faker himself, because you look at that minion kill lead, you look at the effect Faker's going to have in this game. And actually, I believe you know, they never really did much with Elise Kassadin, who could have jumped in, silenced to prevent a flash, prevent a spirit rush away, and chain the cocoon off of it, and then chase down Faker. But now, well, now Faker's got a whole bunch of health. He's level 14. He's got a Negatron cloak. That option no longer exists, not to mention the fact that Mandu started to pink ward everything. The vision control is now SKT's, and they can start strangling even more of the map.
Yeah, as it stands right now, Winds tried to make some ganks happen with that Elise, and you know, he had presence on the map, but it wasn't enough to secure kills or shut down any of SKT's lanes. We'll see Bengi, he's roaming up to this top lane. Does have those home guards, boots of mobility. He really wants to be omnipresent on this map and make sure he has an impact everywhere. Piglet, with that Avarice Blade, earning some additional CS, and trying to work towards what's going to be that static shift. So that's going to be a lot of, you know, on-hit damage for those first couple of shots.
And actually, as the AD carries have gotten more accustomed to Season 3, I believe it was Doublelift said that he actually likes Static Shift a lot more than Phantom Dancer, because team fights now, you have to be very mobile as an AD carry. You're actually going to stack up that Static Shift charge a lot more in team fights. And so even though Phantom Dancer gives you more stats for your Infinity Edge, you're just going to get more Static Shift procs. And Doublelift, if I get the player right, was saying that's actually worth more overall.
We'll see if it works out for Piglet. He's currently 0-1-3. Does have a 20 CS advantage over NL and a fair amount of items. It looks like NL's going for what we've become calling the Legolas build, thanks to Crepo. There's, of course, that Bloodthirster into the likes of a Lost Whisper. And you just start sniping people as a marksman should.
Yeah, you really should there. And honestly, NL's done a very good job of not dying much in fights. And here's going to be interesting. Can Impact survive a 2v1? Yeah, he'll walk away.
Just going to slice and dice out cleanly, and once again, Gamma Bear's trying to make something happen, but not fully invested or fully committing to it. As it stands, Faker is going to spurt rush forward. Sword Art is going to be able to survive for the time being. The Ignite not going to shut him down. Now they dive onto Bengi. Bengi gets caught in place by the Chain of Corruption. Tidal Wave will interrupt the Gamma Bears, and the charm doesn't land. That's a great pickup for the Taiwanese champs.
That's a really good fight for these guys, and they've pretty much all got health bars here. They've got enough to keep pushing forwards. Wins has an Oracle as well. With this 5v4, with pretty much no important ultis available for SKT, many bears could start taking over the map and get some ward coverage back here.
Well, we'll see. As it stands, SKT not necessarily too afraid. Another good charm catches on to Wins, and that Orb of Deception melts his HP bar. But now, Gamma Bears are stacked up as 5. There's no chain or stranglehold. Maple's gone in. That's very brave. He flashes out instantly. Now Impact with Dominus. He's just diving the back line. Gamma Bears can't deal with that immensely tanky Renekton. Ace in the Hole is available for channel, and that's a 4v5 that SKT won.
Yeah, that was really well played by Impact specifically. Two completed items there just sat in the front line taking damage while zoning out the back line himself and didn't allow any counterattack. There was an exhaust used by Mandu, but way more spent by the Bears. And you could just tell SKT are a stronger team right now.
Well, Bengi right now is going to at least take out a bunch of those minions in the mid lane. Stake and Maple doing the best they can to hold onto this top inner turret. There is some decent AoE wave clear, but Stake's going to get into basically spell cast range of SKT, and he takes a lot of damage for doing it. And out defending this mid lane off, this SKT hold onto a 6,000 gold lead and look to set up some more vision control in the jungle of the Gamma Bears.
Well, let's see if they can do it. I mean, honestly, SKT, this is their hallmark thing. This is the thing that makes SKT win games, is the fact that they just control vision so much. And I expect them to start doing this around Baron now. As items get completed, as their front line is tankier, you're going to see them be able to bait the Bears into trying to take Dragon, or trying to stop Baron, I should say, and getting caught. That's the likely play pretty soon for SKT.
Well, we'll see how many vision wards they manage to pick up for themselves. You see that Last Whisper getting closer to being completed for NL. Zeal is the word I'm looking for, in the back pocket of Piglet, as well as a pickaxe. And we see Faker, he's got himself a Negatron Cloak, as well as that BF Sword to go along with his Deathfire Grasp. So he was almost able to take out Sword on their last rotation, but the charm didn't land. So Sword Art was able to flash to safety, and that's really what allowed the Gamma Bears to pick up that frag onto Bengi. You know, SKT, they stayed overextended, they were split up by the Stranglethorns, and it was something that Gamma Bears will have to try to repeat in these coming fights.
But here we go. There's the ward control. There's all the sweeps over on Baron, and let's see which option SKT goes for. They're going to hide in one of these brushes, and Gamma Bears has to do something to know what's going on.
The death bush has been created. They're now hiding around the corner. Stake is pretty tanky. Almost finished that spirit massage. Has a sunfire cape. And we'll see how well Gamma can handle this.
Oh, Wins! Goodbye!
Wins is just taken out, blown away by Faker's Aria. And that's going to allow SKT to secure this blue buff. There's no smite available, so we'll have to see if they want to go for what's going to be a pretty safe Baron.
Yeah, there's no jungler. There's no smite steal even possible. None of these champions have individual spike abilities either. The thing is, SKT could always bait for another kill, but Gamma Bears has to realize they can't stop Baron. They should just go for a turret or something instead.
We'll see what they decide to do. As it stands, they are once again grouped up as a four-man, moving closer and closer. Mandu, can he land the bubble? Aqua Prism's being charged. He doesn't manage to connect in the background. Stake is still alive. Dragon's Descent out. That's a great Stranglethorn. Will at least interrupt SK Telecom. Bengi's the first victim of the fight, but it's soon going to be much more of the Gamma Bears down. That's a double kill for Impact as he continues to chase down. Another kill for Faker, and everybody but Wins is dead.
Yeah, Wins is stuck in the base anyway. He's just coming out right now. It's a 4-for-1 battle, and you face checked into a team with all their abilities up, and even with a Zyra ulti, there is just so much chase potential. Bengi sacrificing his life to lock down the back line. And what do you know? Faker landed a bunch of great charms, guaranteed the kills here. And now, with 15 seconds, SKT can get an inhibitor and back to base.
Going to be able to secure this tower. They're going to bash away on this inhibitor. Piglet in the background has lost a little bit of HP. Huh. They decide to play it safe. The death timers are still fairly short. You can see all Gammas respawning. Here's a replay.
Yeah, so they do then the charm on the stake, deal a bunch of damage, get him out of the fight. That tidal wave hits everybody on the bears, and it's just easy damage onto the back line. You can see how well SKT are able to chase down. That max range charm on Maple was pretty important to make sure they got those last few kills, but that's what these guys can do. This is a very, very mechanically proficient team who set up that fight perfectly.
Yeah, Faker does not miss those charms when they count. Manages to secure yet more kills. He's 3-0-4 as his Deathfire Grasp completed. Now, the Gamma Bears are stacked up in this mid lane. NL is trying to apply damage on the tower. They've brought Faker out. They are going to jump in. We do see Wins is the one that secures the killing blow. Now, Mandu's the next target. They have not taken the tower out. As now we see that Piglet has come to defend. He does have red buff on, and he's putting a lot of hurt down as he's
caught
up. The silence goes out. He instantly cleanses it away. Bengi's on the retreat. Piglet's on the retreat, and the Gamma Bears are holding strong 5v3. Here comes Impact! Dominus is ticking. He's taking on 5 members of the Gamma Bears, and they don't have the bite. Ace in the hole, threading the needle. Tidal Wave comes down, and the Gamma Bears are drowning under the pressure of SK Telecom. Impact is still alive. He's been tanking up the Bears for 3 full minutes, and Impact finally backs away. 2 kills on the board for SKT.
That becomes a 2-for-2 fight despite the free kill onto Faker, which was an excellent play, to be completely fair. But that's what happened when Impact is huge. SKT said it would be on him to be important. Yeah, they said it. Their top lane is going to be important for this matchup. Just watch Impact here. Dives in to get the reset and jumps on the AD carry, kills him for free, kites out some of the damage, makes sure no one can jump back in. He is basically single-handedly removing the back line of Gamania Bears.
SK Telecom secure the dragon as well on their way out there. Now 6 kills ahead, 10,000 gold, and have yet to lose a turret right now, defending all of their outer turrets. And Gamma Bears, they found a good pick, but maybe just stuck around a little too long in that mid lane. They're now falling even further behind. We do see that Piglet's got himself those Fira boots completed, and he's also working towards his Last Whisper.
The Gamma Bears needed to really choose one, because once they were all in, Impact wasn't in that fight yet, and they had time for a 5v4. The exhaust was used early on Maple before he cast any spells, and he didn't have to lose any damage by doing that. They get the catch on a Bengi, but Bengi's really big.
Yeah, there's a lot of tankiness there. He does have his locket available. Stake does get caught out on that Aqua Prism, but the first tower falls. Gamma Bears clawing back some of their gold difference.
Yeah, they're going to try. Honestly, getting some of these turrets is really nice, and a lot of that, I think, they were relying on Stake's Shyvana, who is hard to chase. She has a movement speed buff. She can, you know, jump really, really far in dragon form, but because Impact has won the 1v1 so well, because Faker is so huge, any one of those guys can just stop Stake's pushing whenever, and that's actually removing a lot of what would have been the Bears' mid lane pressure is they don't have a real split pusher. It's not Teleport Kassadin, it's Ignite Kassadin. So no one gets to do anything by themselves here for the Bears.
As it stands right now, SKT, they played the Baron game a couple minutes ago. It worked out in their favor, winning 2 team fights back to back. Now they are a little bit split up. In actual fact, though, Gamma Bears may be the ones that are in trouble. Dominus has been used by Impact. He's dove in. He's between 4. We'll see how much damage he can put down. The Stranglethorns is up. Instantly deleted is Sword Art and Stake forced to retreat. They have caught Faker, though. They've traded mid laner for support. The Gamma Bears are not doing badly as Maple is retreating over on the background. But look at that Aqua Prism. That locks up NL. They managed to secure the kill. Impact and Mandu are chasing. Vaultbreaker catches Wins. Now he's the next target as Piglet is going to 90 caliber over the wall. Doesn't get sight for Ace in the hole, but they trade 1-for-2.
That was a very, very good team fight. Once again by SKT, you had Impact on one side. And it's like, well, we either run into the other team and Impact flanks our backline, or we run into Impact and we just don't kill him. So SKT got a surround there. They got a very good Nami ult as well. And they're rewarded with, honestly, this is not a contestable Baron.
Well, Stake is sticking around. Does look like he has his ultimate available. We'll see if he decides to dive in. Piglet is zoning Stake out. Burnout is ticking. Now Stake, once again, not taking as much damage from Piglet
as
we thought. They've actually backed away. Boomandu doesn't land the prison, and they were able to at least interrupt that Baron. So well played by Gamma Bears, and more importantly, Stake. That was well done.
I don't know why Piglet was the one to defend the guy jumping in, because he has the highest single target DPS on that team. Any other person could have been able to spot who was coming in and still allow the damage to come through, because still, Wins was far away from that fight. But regardless, good job by Bears to hold on. They've managed to not give any other leads to SKT. But what I have to ask, though, is who's actually going to get rid of Impact in these fights? He's a 5-0-5 Renekton, 320 minions in 31 minutes, and no one's been able to kill him so far, and I think it's pretty unlikely that no one but the Fountain Laser ever does in this game.
I completely agree with that. He's only got himself a Randian Zoman, a Spirit Visage, a Sunfire Cape, and a Hex Drinker. I don't think he has enough items right now, and as it stands, there's nobody from Gamma that can deal with him. We'll see whether or not Gamma Bears can find more of those picks. They've had some success in it, but they are still 10,000 gold down.
And that's the unfortunate side effect of the Legolas build, is you never get the Infinity Edge for a very long time, which is a really core and very key damage multiplier for single target damage output. Anyone but Impact, great. He's going to snipe them. His Qs will deal 600 damage or so. He even has a Static Shift burst to follow up. That's all wonderful. But you can't burst a Renekton, and this is part of the reason Impact is getting untouched in these fights.
Well, we'll see how well it works out for them. Once again, Gamma Bears are stacking up in this mid lane. Stake and Impact, they're going toe-to-toe for a while. But you see now Impact has dived in. Dominus is channeling. Stake still yet to use Dragon's Descent. Tidal Wave comes in from the background. Does manage to catch two Sword Art and NL in trouble. That was a good Stranglethorn, but NL is down. That's a lot of Gamma Bears damage. Removed Wins is going to be the second kill of the fighters. Now they turn onto Sword Art. That's going to be a triple kill for Piglet. If they can get some CC onto Maple, he'll be in trouble. And you see him actually flashing forward, but Maple was able to get away. We did see Stake going down in the background, but this is an exposed inhibitor that SKT will secure.
This is going to be a very, very easy win for these guys. And if they want, they really could go for Baron afterwards. The inhibitor goes down. They say,
we've got
minions instead. They might be able to get this.
There are minions pouring in from behind them. They land the charm. Maple is down. SK Telecom all of a sudden decide to win a team fight, decide to close the game out. And the Gamma Bears are going to drop 0-1 in this best of three series.
This is a 33-minute game, and SKT are one Nexus away for being one of the top four teams in the World Championship here for Season 3. A team that got thrown together just a few months ago, and they're already poised to take the entire world.
SK Telecom playing slower, and I think feeling out their opponents, the Gamma Bears, as it stood in those lanes, didn't see too many aggressive moves, and we actually seen NL and Sword Art doing very well against Piglet and Boomandu, but
yeah,
just couldn't build the lead for the Gamma Bears.
Yeah, and that's just the sort of, they didn't get the option to make a lot of plays. The run for Dragon was very smart, it was well timed, they had pushed the mid laner out and knew that with the core damage dealer gone in the mid game, then great, they can go take a global objective. And the actual laning mechanics were pretty good for the Bears. Okay, there was a gank without a ward, that was a little bit rough. Eventually the bottom lane turnaround, that was a little bit rough, but there is a pretty good early game for the Bears. They just couldn't find more things to do, which was a big weakness.
Yeah, I definitely think that Wins is going to need to make those ganks work, because I feel like he tried about four, five, six times during the early stages of the game, but just didn't really get anything, you know, impactful or meaningful.